Hey guys, your boy Coopers, and welcome back to my favorite 16 at Liverpool Chroma, where last time I left off, I won the league. Before I even played my league game against Bournemouth, I secured the league title. Oh, because while I was completing my victory over LA Bilba, in the Champions League. No drop the points I needed them to drop, and which crowned me the champions for the third consecutive season. Now, in episodes I did simulate the Manchester United game, as you can see, it ended 2-1 to me. Wayne Rooney getting Manchester United's goal, when the goals for me came from Marek Laporte and Gareth Bale. Cool. I was gonna play the game, but I had confidence that the team could do the business without me at the helm, and I had no fear that for the undefeated record, and I was right to have the confidence because they got the job done, and with the Welshman himself getting the winning goal. I can't tell you whether the goals were any good or not, because like I said, I simulated the game, I didn't play it. I imagine Laporte's might have been a header. I'm just weighing the options. As for Bale, I mean, it could have easily been a long-range screamer, because we know Bale is very good at those. Obviously, he has the cheering trait in the game. You guys can decide. Were the good goals good or were they not? The great thing is, no one knows who's right, so we'll have fun with that. As you see, I'm playing with the second team for the first leg. The first leg is a home game. Him as I welcome. And Bayer Leverkusen, and former Liverpool striker Daniel Sturridge, who I sold to Bayer Leverkusen, remember? Very good to see Danny Sturridge back, there he is.
Against Manchester
United. We'll keep him quiet. And this is, this is perfect, because I'm going to be talking about the Europa League match against Borussia Dortmund. And I happen to be playing a Champions League match against another German team in Bayer Leverkusen. So what are the odds? It's fate. But oh my god. I mean, if I hadn't witnessed Istanbul on the telly, I'd say that was the best match that I've ever seen. But Unfortunately for Borussia Dortmund, the game is the Istanbul game did happen, and wow, straight away Daniel Sturridge has opened the scoring. That's bad.
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0.
Well, let's not forget Liverpool went 2-0 down inside 10 minutes to Borussia Dortmund, and that ended 4-3. I'm not going to be aiming to concede 3 goals.
It means the ball moves.
Yeah, bad start. Again, like in life. But I'm not going to let it. I'm not aiming to repeat that with another German club. I'm not going for symbolism here. Or just because I'm playing with German foot.
It's a good block.
But yeah, the game was absolutely amazing, and hence the without, if you've not seen it, even if you don't support either one of the clubs, it is probably the best match you can watch. In fact, it's probably better if you're a neutral, because I can't speak for Dortmund fans, but as a Liverpool fan, I was damn near. I don't know how I didn't lose my breath, how I didn't lose my voice. I was shouting at the telly. The passion was off the chart. It was amazing. If you're neutral, I don't care what team you support. I don't care if you support Man United. I don't care if you support Chelsea, Bayern Munich, Real Madrid, Barcelona, Manchester City. It doesn't matter. If you watch this game, you won't regret it. It is practically the best game for neutral that you are likely to find.
Was not the best of challenges. No impact on the game yet from Liverpool.
From a support standpoint, if you support one of the two teams, it's obviously better if you're a Liverpool fan. And, I mean, there's points that the Dortmund fans can enjoy, except for the part where they lost. And, you know, I almost feel bad for the Dortmund fans. Because the game was so good, it almost feels like a crime that someone had to lose that match. Don't get me wrong, I'm glad it was Dortmund and not Liverpool, because I'm a Liverpool supporter. But you know, it does almost feel like a bit of a crime that's the way it goes. That's the way football goes a lot. And, It's definitely worth the watch. Find the highlights. Strap yourself in. And even though you know the score, you can still enjoy the 90 minutes of absolutely breathtaking football. Like I said, it's probably the best game you're ever going to watch as a neutral in football.
So you can't explain it away by
I mean,
the board shows 3 added minutes.
I realize it's not the highest scoring game there's ever been. I mean, I know there was like a 5-4 between Arsenal and Spurs 1 year, but this game had, you know, it's almost hard to describe, except for saying that the match was brilliant. And even though they lost, I'm comfortable in going on a limb and saying the Dortmund fans would agree that the match was very, very good. The only down point they tell you is that they lost. I mean, they had the 3 goals, and their team, for most part, didn't play bad. They kind of dropped off in the last couple of minutes. I'm not the only one who noticed that. The BT analysts noticed that as well, that they seem to be dropping off of it after a few moments. And really, and maybe you were wrong, who knows, but that could be the case and it might not be the case. Either way, it's definitely worth a watch. Whether you're a supporter of one of the two teams or you're a neutral, it's definitely, it's breathtaking football at its very best. Anyway, I think I've talked enough about the fantastic game between Liverpool and Borussia Dortmund. Let's now turn our attention to this game here between me and Bayer Leverkusen. While I was talking, I did equalize through Nicolas Sulp. Costa. Go for Origi! Oh! He got a goal against Borussia Dortmund. In fact, he got 2 goals. He scored in both legs. in fact, the only player who scored in two in both legs, because Dortmund's goal scorer, or Mark Hummels, is he as good as Matt, because we also have him. Oh, it's a penalty! That is brilliant. Chance for me to take the lead. Thank you, Toprak. Got a chance for me to take the lead. Iheanacho. Oh, this is actually a very big moment for Iheanacho. Oh, Leno saves it! Leno with the save! And this is why I want a keeper like Leno at Liverpool. Oh, that is what he is capable of. Fantastic save. He gets the right.
What do you make of this?
Wait, could I have done better? Perhaps, but that's just
a yellow card.
Without doubt,
the case sometimes. And as I was saying, it would have been a huge goal for Iheanacho. But why would I say that? Because I looked at the squad report, and Iheanacho over the season has scored 23 goals. And you're probably saying, that is brilliant. But why would 24 be a special goal? Surely 25 would be the special goal. 24, if he had scored that penalty, he would have leveled his season tally with Angel Correa. And Angel Correa has played 40 games over the course of the season in all competitions. This is Iheanacho's 22nd game. Meaning he has so far played 18 games less and is only one goal less throughout the whole season.
Well, Liverpool go up against Manchester City.
When I saw that, I was like, wait, what? So you're telling me that one of my backup strikers is only one less goal than someone I've played 18 more times? It's crazy. Iheanacho is probably gonna end up with more goals than Correa, unless Correa goes on a mad goal scoring run at the end of the season, and like Iheanacho, who for some reason was not to score any more goals.
Why would he try the shot from there? Maybe once in training he's put it in the top corner.
Yeah, that was just a selfish act. Really, I think he's lost his head completely with that decision.
Turbe. Ah! Ta, who I'm looking at in the summer. Cheeky little transfer reveal there. I'm interested in signing Ta as a center back for Liverpool. I'm thinking of him as a replacement for that man right there, Orban. Orban's not bad, but you know, he's just. And there's that's it. That is the final whistle. 1-1 has ended. That gives Bayer Leverkusen a bit of an advantage going into the second leg with that away goal. No, that is heavily disappointing. And see, I do have a game against Manchester City, but I'm going to sim that. Because, as you guys know, I already have the wig. I don't have a wig. Why would I have a wig? I just got my hair cut. I'm not ashamed. It's a fantastic haircut. You can't see. Actually, you'll see. You will have seen it in the review video earlier today. Interesting. Anyway, but yeah. I've already won the league, so even if Manchester City were to defeat me, it's not going to matter. The league is comfortably returning to Anfield. I didn't even lose, because it's a 1-0 win over 10-man Manchester City. And I scored before they went down to 10-man, so... Oh, 6 minutes before, and to be precise. The only problem is, Marco Reus looks like he picked up an injury, but he didn't go off until the 86th minute. And the injury must have happened before the Neymar goal, because it doesn't show it. So hopefully it's not too bad. I mean, if he played on until the 86th minute, it must not have been that bad. Out for, did that say 3 days or 3 weeks? I did see a 3 days. He's out for 3 days. He is out for 3 days. What a waste of everyone's time. Seriously, what is the point of those kind of injuries? If it's not a serious injury, don't tell me about it. 3 days. I don't have a game in 3 days that he's going to play in. Reus isn't playing in the return leg against Bayer Leverkusen. Well, on the second, the mainstream players will be on the bench. And I'm going to jump me with my second string team. But I'm going to use the other variation of it. And actually, I have to change it. So I'm going to use this version of the second team with Donza and Wilson instead of Costa and Can, who actually used to play for Brighton, because, you know, one point to the Emery Chan. A little bit of footballing history there for you. Yeah. For those of you who, for some reason, did not know that. And I don't know who you would be, but... You know, it could be some of you there. And a pure... You know, just in case, I'm going to have my main boys on the bench. And offensively, Coutinho and Bale for the midfield, and Neymar and Correa for the strike force. Of course, I could put Neymar in the midfield as well. One still, and he'd do the job fantastically. I do want to be kept up to date with the game at the San Siro, where the real-life Champions League final is being held this year. Competition is now down to 4. Both Madrid's and Bayern Munich and Manchester City. And poor deluded pundits on Gillette Soccer Saturday. They actually think Man City have a chance against Real Madrid. Those poor fucking imbeciles. Seriously. Manchester City. I mean, they have good players. Don't get me wrong. Man City have good players. And Raheem Sterling. But they're not winning the Champions League. They're not getting past Real Madrid. No, Sturridge might score again. And this time I get it away. You know, Alberto Moreno doing the heavy work.
Ease the pressure.
Donza wins the ball. Oh, Iheanacho still looking to get back to get level with Correa. Can he do it there? No! Oh! How did they keep that out?
Sturridge.
And no draw actually is good enough for
Kramer.
For the Germans. Since they go through on away goals.
Weak challenge. Well, he must have heard us up here. He's certainly.
I'm going to assume that they don't want to do that. Or else they'd be on, like, park the bus and playing flat back. They are not doing that, so clear that they came to win.
Manager, because we're hearing that he's been offered the chance to manage.
I came to win too.
On a part-time basis to keep this job.
Yeah, I mean, he's got to be careful.
Ring. He's looking for Iron Nacho. Iron Nacho. Oh, pulls back. Tadonza! Oh!
He wants to play on the shoulder of the last defender.
And Ivers offside. I was wondering why the play stopped. I was like, surely he hasn't given him the penalty.
Seen a pass, cut it out, and in the wing area now can maybe attack. Daniel Sturridge. It'll be a throw
now for a Borussia mission. I mean, Bayer Leverkusen. I'm getting my German teams confused. Ah, so many German teams. So little time.
What we've got here today is a cup game.
Leverkusen. I'm playing Leverkusen. Sorry, just had to get that into my head.
The team that we're really looking at here, Alan, the manager has really started the match.
Very easily cleared there by Mathieu de Scuba. Iturbe. Iheanacho. Can somebody make a run here, please? Thank you. Iturbe. Donza. And it's gone out off Donza. It's a Leverkusen throw. Burr. Bellarabi actually kept that in.
Kramer. Will be fair throw.
It's out off Wilson for another Leverkusen throw. Son.
Kramer.
Sturridge. Orban doing his job defensively. Here's Iturbe. Does it straight away. And Nicholas Sewell pulled a big my big German in coming up trumps against the Germans. Yeah, when you face Germans, bring out the Germans!
Really strong tackle, and the ball's gone out for a throw.
Why the hell not? Top.
Daniel Sturridge.
Alberto Moreno. Gives it straight back to Leverkusen.
Papadopoulos. Son. Bentleno. One extra minute before the whistle goes.
Yes. Donza, go. Go. Good tackle by Top. Had to prevent the first time cross and first header is the last touch of the first half. Okay, so far, they're still going through with that away goal. Well, but it's not time for the big guns yet. Still have faith in the second string. Come on, Iturbe. Hey. Oh, he shrugs off the challenge like a boss. That's Divo Origi. No, he can't get the ball through. It's cleared away. Donza. Loses the ball straight away, God.
Well, the word average comes to mind about his first half. What do you think, Alan?
He's been a shadow of his normal self out there. So unlike him, and hasn't had a chance, hardly.
Son. Very good passes. His team are passing the ball beautifully. Well, that's a good challenge between the two of them there.
No! Oh! No! Yes, Dragoski. He with a fantastic save. Greedy. Go with Iturbe, go. Greedy. Mathieu de Scuba. Whips it in. Back. Post.
It's good work between these two. Bellarabi.
Okay, I think it's time. It is time. But the question is, who do I bring on? Turby and Wilson look tired, so I'm going to bring on Gareth Bale and Philippe Coutinho. Coutinho there. And we're going to play the same way the main squad do. With Hermit right behind the camp. And then Donza said Tillemans by Coutinho. Tillemans by Tillemans is not on the bench. And the foul will now mean in the introduction of the Brazilian and the Welshman. Donza.
Schilio.
Gareth Bale. Yeah, the fresh Welsh legs. The fresh Welsh legs. Gareth Bale. Pulls it back. Ah, oh, there's nobody there. Coutinho was in the wrong place. That's okay. There's like a void over here or some description. Door knife. Ah, oh, it's off a bender.
Clear corner.
They're bringing on Kiesling. They're going to give everyone a cake if they win. Make the cake a lie. Make this poor one. Oh, it's almost Coutinho. That's nowhere near.
I'm sure they've got it right. We can see.
Well, they definitely have. I mean,
door knife. To Coutinho. Oh.
It's another corner for them.
I think another substitution is needed. Sorry, and I'm not sure you're not going to get the chance to level with Correa. I'm bringing on Mr. for 30 plus goals. It's time for Neymar. It's gone straight all the way to Alberto Moreno. Oh, here's Donza. Divo Origi! Yes! Divo Origi, you Belgian beast! Yes!
Do the basics defensively properly from here on in. And he's just put his foot through this.
His 12th goal in the Champions League. Get in, you legend! I'm bringing on Neymar. That almost always seems to happen almost every time I play an offensive substitution and someone scores for me.
Now they've got to find a goal from someone.
It's okay. That's okay, that works. That is fantastic. If anything. Here is Origi, the goal scorer. Sure. Looking for Neymar. Off. This is yes.
The goalkeeper, and he's hung on to the ball.
He was pulled back.
1-0 here.
That should be a free kick.
It's impacting on their next game.
Oh, Todd has made a mistake. Neymar. Oh, would you believe it? Would you actually freaking believe it? I need another goal to be sure, because this a goal for them would send us to extra time. I don't know about that. Ah, oh, the ball. Oh, goes straight to left. Oh, Donza in. And on the end of the third ball. I'll take one for the team. I might be a red, but that's okay. Hey, even if that's a red, that's okay. Yeah, it's a red. Straight red card. Yeah, that's what I thought it would be. It's called take one for the team if it means. Since we don't go to extra time. Get rid of that.
Kiesling,
he's missed. There's the full-time whistle. Yes.
Whew. They've got through on aggregate this quarter-final, and their thrilling cup run goes on.
Yeah, I think the excitement levels have just been ratcheted up a notch or two. They can almost touch that final now.
Yes! And there's the man who made it all possible. I am through to the semi-final, thanks to Divock Origi, you legend. Real Madrid beat Inter Milan 3-2, 4-2 on aggregate, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, indeed. The second legs in the Europa quarterfinals have not happened. Yeah, as you can see, Barcelona are going in 0-0 to their second leg, and Bayern are all but through against Monaco. Oh, so we're just really waiting to see if Barcelona will be shocked or will the usual suspects be the four final semi-finalists in the Champions League. Barcelona beat Fenerbahce 3-2. Oh, Fenerbahce must feel sick after that. 2-2 would have been enough to send them through. Although, it could have easily been two goals and they just didn't get the third one. So, it is the usual suspects. Next, the final four of the Champions League are me, Bayern Munich, Barcelona, and Real Madrid. Four teams you pretty much expect. Next episode, I have the semi final against Newcastle in the FA Cup. The winner will face Watford or Arsenal. I almost said Newcastle. How could Newcastle play themselves if they were to beat me? That would be bizarre. The question is, am I going to Spain or Germany? Spain against Barcelona! Ooh! So from Spain to Germany, back to Spain! Brilliant! And I will have another Spanish club in Real Madrid in the final, or I'll be playing another German team in Bayern Munich! But the way it's been going, it's probably going to be Bayern Munich! Would your money be on Bayern Munich? They actually lost the second leg 2-1. As I previously stated, that goal would have just extra secured this. So yeah, in the next episode I will have that game against Newcastle. Oh. And the first leg against Barcelona is at the Camp Nou, or is it's at the Camp Nou? Which means I could go into that second leg with all important away goal. There's no way I'm playing the second string against Barcelona against Messi and Suarez and whoever they got to replace Neymar. So yeah. Do not miss the next episode. It's going to be a huge episode. I'll be vying for a spot in the final of the FA Cup and the first leg against Barcelona. So don't you dare miss it. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.